I'm not going to show you macroeconomic picture. I wrote an article last week interviewing a Nobel laureate, Edward Prescott. Some of you are on my e-list, so you would have read it. Mr. Vinay Kotak is there. So those things we do. But I'm going to be practical here because most of you are Gujaratis. So let me be a Gujarati. I'm not a Gujarati. I'm a Tamil Brahmin. That's a different story. We don't care about money, but I know you care about money. So I'm going to only take this 15 minutes they have given to show you and counter what others have said so far. Mr. Mohit Shah said that there is polyester is on a higher rise and there is no meaningful counter from cotton in terms of innovation. Coincidentally, I didn't know what he was talking, but I'm going to say that is not true. And I have a product to show, all from cotton, all from discounted cotton, all from low micronar cotton. I come from Lubbock, which is the largest cotton going contiguous patch, 41 counties. Somewhere or other along the stretch, cotton is there. You can see end of the world, most of you would have come to Lubbock, Suresh Bhai Kotak, Nayan Mirani, they all came in 2007. Hope they are here. So they know what is happening. So 20% of that cotton, 5.5 million bales from High Plains, comes below the base range of 3.4. That's what it is. I work on low micronar. Genetics cannot do anything. Kranti can counter me. Micronar is one thing which is dependent on weather. Okay, they talked about 2 to 4 cents discount to Brazilian and West African cotton. I'm talking about 6 cents per pound discount. So I'm going to take that product and tell you how to create a new market. So you people are in business only if you create demand, because it's still supply side economics. Supply and demand. So supply, if you, so far people are focused on yield and supply. What do you do if you have a lot of supply? Ganatra will not have business. You'll go down. So now Mr. Seksheria comes. So I'm here because of you. So I want to make him look good by showing how to increase the market. One, increase the market. Create more value for the cotton. Two things. So as a businessman, you people would be interested in this. So that's what I'm going to tell you now. 10 minutes. I've already taken 2 to 3 minutes. 10 minutes and then 4 minutes, I will do an actual demo of a product that became viral in YouTube. So cotton can still do innovation beyond genetics. Cotton can still create value-added product. Whether you call it as a technical textile, industrial textile, name doesn't matter. All matters is new market. Can new markets be created out of cotton? That's what Mr. Mohit Shah challenged. So I'm going to counter him. So and you will be seeing it. So this is what it is. I do it in two ways. This is not working. Okay. So I never talk to anybody before, but this is what we do. So I'm going to tell you, to make cotton, I'm not going to alter any more third generation or fourth generation BT. I'm not going to talk about it. With what you have now, that's what will make me better than others here. I should not come and preach something from lofty angle and preach lofty goals. I should tell you what it is practical. So that's what I'm going to do. To find new applications and create new markets for cotton. And that too, I'm going to only deal with below base range cotton, 2.8 to 3.4, that base range cotton, so that if I could do a magic to that cotton, there is a game changer. Why? Because one advantage cotton has still, why we are in business. You can't compete against synthetics. Mr. Vijji is here, so I can challenge. It's difficult because everything is structured. Length is structured, no contamination. Volume is structured. Once the volume is structured, the volatility is less. When the volatility is right, you have a fixed market system. The dynamics is controlled. which is not possible in cotton. So you are dealing with a fiber that's a nuisance per se. Right. So that's what it, but cotton is in business. Mr. Ranaday said that 5 billion people use cotton, but why cotton is in business? Cotton is in business because it is pre-sold. You know, Americans are good in selling refrigerator to an Eskimo. So that's why we got to learn a bit. So cotton is pre-sold because of its comfort. The next marketing gig you people have to use is its pre-selling capability. Cotton is pre-sold because of its comfort. And cotton is in business because it is degradable over a period of time, which synthetics cannot do. I believe in God. So the God has done the trick to cotton. So we have to play the game within these two margins, the comfort, which synthetics cannot do, which Indorama fiber cannot do per se, because it's a solid fiber. My PhD was on synthetics, right? But then I switched to cotton when I moved to Texas, okay? Second thing, it degrades on its own. So cotton is in business because of its comfort, because of its degradability, closeness to the land, okay? So the advantages I have said. And this is what I am going to show you. And this is a regular base range cotton cellulose. Let's not go into chemistry. But what happens because of weather, this cellulose deposition doesn't take place. When the cellulose deposition is not taking place, the secondary wall growth doesn't happen. So it doesn't pick up dyes. When it doesn't pick up dyes, it's going to be immature. Whereas the fineness value where you get micronar is not a color correct indication. Let's not go into all these chemistries. It is not going to give you the premium value what you need. And if it's not mature enough, it's going to be brittle enough, so it will not elongate and extend, so the spindle breakage will be more. These are all the technicalities behind the reason why you are not getting value for your cotton, which is not the case with synthetics. So I'm going to do two things. One is, I'm going to develop high-value product out of cotton. I'm not just going to put slide. This is a high-value product out of cotton. And then second thing, I'm going to, which they didn't give me time to talk about it because they only gave me 15 minutes for coming 10,000 miles. Okay. So I'm not going to show you on how I dye cotton without water. I was talking to Dr. Rajan Nachne. We are planning to do a special symposium on how to dye cotton without water. So wait and watch for it. Using supercritical carbon dioxide process. Chinese are ahead of it, but you can still catch. So now I'm going to tell you how I took a low micronar cotton, this one, and then converted into a single use, whereas the undergarment, all that 7 billion people which Dr. Ranaday alluded to wear undergarment, underwear out of cotton. But even a world's richest man is not going to throw away that undergarment after single use, to my knowledge. Maybe he or she does, I don't know. But I am going to create more supply. That's what Mr. Suresh Bhai Kotak challenged me in 2011 when he came to visit my lab. He's not there. I hope he gets better soon. I am going to develop a product which is single use. Understand this concept. If you are developing a product which is single use, what am I going to do? I'm going to increase the demand. So I'm going to work on basics. I'm not going to do all this economics because economics doesn't matter. Sometimes they tell things which you don't understand. Most of the times they are incorrect. Leave it. So true. I was with a Nobel laureate last week, so I didn't understand a single thing what he told. That's a different story. So I'm going to increase the demand. You are talking about increasing the supply. Who is clever? The guy who increases demand is clever, right? And then I'm going to put that supply into a high-value product. I'm not going to put that product into a denim or an undergarment. I'm going to put that product, which people don't know what it is, but they are willing to pay more price. That is the trick. That is the trick of success in biotech industry. That is the trick of success in pharmaceutical industry. That is the trick
in IT sector. Textile is a lagger. That is what I'm going to do. What we are familiar, we all know this. I stole from Trident, but I'll return it back. This is the product which you are all familiar. So I'm going to go and then do the demo. So and then anybody who wants to try, I may ask Mr. Chokalingam to come. He is my senior in the college. So we have been friends for a long time. So this is what I'm going to do. This is the actual cotton product you all have seen. Okay. What does this product do? It takes up water immediately. So it becomes heavy. So you got to dry. Whereas if I take, this is a low micron, wait a minute. This is a low micron or cotton on a single use synthetic pad, but inside is cotton. I'll show you that. I'm pouring this water. You saw that. That absorbs water. When it absorbs water, that water has to be dried. This is what the textile industry is feeling the pinch, because it has to dry that cotton, whether it is finished, whether it is dyed, or whether it is washed, whether it is thrown. You talked about high moisture content. That's the problem. Now this will repel water. See? Okay. Whereas you saw this, it will not repel the water. Now it's totally dry. It won't even come to the other side. It will come here on the other side. So first thing, what I have used is a low micron or cotton. What did we find? Nobody found. Even Kranti missed it. So okay, let's go quickly. Push the slide, please. Push the slide. Push it. All these I explained. Low micronair, base range, yada, yada, yada. Now, go to the scanning microscope. This is the one you people should know. Hold on. So this is what happens. If you take a low micronair cotton, how many had seen the cross-section of a low micronair cotton? Kanti would have done it, right? He's sitting in the back. So that's what happens. You see lot of very few ribbon-like structure. Most of them are flat structure. So when they are flat structure, the empty is vacuum, so the dye doesn't pick up. So that's the thing. This is a beautiful picture of cotton and a scanning electron microscope. You cut across the cotton. Traders should interact with scientists, right? Scientists can help you to make more money. So don't discard scientists like us. So that's what happens. So when it is flat, it collapses. It will break. But that is a blessing for an industrial cotton plaque. When it is collapsing, it's spreading. When it is spreading, it can take heavy liquid. Water is not a heavy liquid. Water is less viscous, whereas oil is heavy. So the oil will go and fill up the gaps. And then the gap, you know, low micronair has a lot of lumen, high vacuum inside. I'm talking layman's term, but scientists call it as a lumen. It functions as a channel, and it will hold a viscous liquid, which a bleached cotton, this cannot do. So when there is that kind of liquid, a viscous liquid like oil, it will hold the oil, and it will separate water. So that's what you are going to see now. So this is the science behind it. Now I will show you the demonstration. So this is the actual product. I gave it to India for free. A company in Chennai has been exporting it. This month they exported 6,000 pieces to Houston. It's called Velgro Tech. That's my invention. But India owns it now. So this is a product. When you cut across that product, this is the low micronair cotton. Uncleaned low micronair cotton is there. But that IP is protected. We were the first one to show why low micronair cotton, discounted cotton, does the trick. So this Sudha Ben brought it to me. So this is your parachute oil, but Seksheria did this with a crude oil. See, water rippled, it's dry, but oil will be instantaneously absorbed. See, water is still there, like mercury on a lotus leaf. Water is still there. You can come yourself and touch it. Mr. Ganatra, you can come and do the experiment. See, the oil will be absorbed. It will stick. It won't flow. Whereas simultaneously, I'm going to pour the water, it will ripple instantaneously. See, whereas oil is held. Why? Because that oil quickly penetrates, you see, still oil is held. And then the cotton inside, the low micronair cotton inside, see, I'm just putting it purposely. So even under gravity, gravitational pull, water will drop down. See, oil will not drop down. That is because this portion does the trick. And this is 15 by 19. Hardly it is 20 paise cotton used. 15 by 19, hang on, I'll tell you, you're a businessman, you should know the margin. 30 paise. Houston oil and crude oil industry pays $2.50 for this piece. Where is 30 cents? Where is $2.50? You go to Google, hit Wellgro Tech, WellGroTech.com. India is the only country right now, of course, that was my brain, leave it like that. So that, but Indians are good in making jugadu. Whereas we came up with the IP, but we were not good enough to make it as a package. Chokalingam was telling me that package is also important, right? So they were able to make this package. So this is one product margin. Imagine 50 paise, $2.50. You have iPhone, now do it. WellgroTech.com, they have listed all the prices. And still now, you see, I'm not lying. It's still held. You can see, you see, water all not going inside. Oil is held. That is from low micro. Nobody, you talk about 100 years of Cotton Association of India, nobody had thought about it. Even Texas A&M, they have a lot of ICAC, cotton researchers of the world. They have concentrated. That's the problem. So far, people have concentrated. Kranti is laughing. That's the difference. So far, people have concentrated on yield. But there is going to be saturation no matter what. People have then focused on quality, both at farm level and off the farm level. Even United States cotton growers are struggling. They did not focus. Whether you take Australians, Europeans are not into cotton research anymore, so leave them. Australians or we in the United States,